statement we created for BGI was that it's an integrated approach to the philosophy, science, and art of chiropractic, building bridges between osseous, tonal, and postural models. And so for me, one of the first things that it does is it takes a look at our philosophy and asks the question, you know, which I think any philosophical understanding does, it begs the question, is what we say accurate? And does it make sense? And does it really embody everything that we say we are? And for me, there are things about our philosophy that do and things about our philosophy that really don't. You know, I love the general things about our philosophy, that there is this organizing intelligence, that it exists everywhere and nowhere at the same time, and that really it coordinates, inspires, heals, motivates every action and reaction that we have. That makes perfect sense to me, based on what I experience every day and based on what I know of physics. That it can be interfered with makes perfect sense to me, right? That it has perfection makes perfect sense to me. The things that don't make sense to me is the whole thing. Now, let me preface this by saying, things that don't make sense to me on an expanded level are often different than what we might experience every single day, right? So, example, the concept that healing takes time. Yeah, sometimes, sometimes not, you know? Healing can be instantaneous, and two, how do you measure healing? You know, if healing is, well, my symptoms went away, many people experience that, yeah, sometimes that takes time, but sometimes not. You get what I mean? I mean, there's just things that I'm like, the whole idea that limits of matter is really problematic to me, because matter, ultimately, if you break it down, is energy, and we wouldn't put the same limits on energy that we do matter. Right? And so that thing, you know, philosophically is problematic to me. The whole concept that universal forces are destructive and innate forces are constructive, that whole judgment of good, bad is challenging to me, because if universal intelligence is perfect, it's perfect. And it may be comfortable or uncomfortable, but come on, from a philosophical place, it all just is. There is no good and bad. There's no black and white. It just is. And because it is, there's a perfection in it. And so you get how screwy my mind is sometimes. And so there were things like that that were problematic for me that I needed to reach a peace with. And I don't feel like I need to go into the whole resolution of all these ideas unless you want to later. But ultimately, what this led me to, philosophically and scientifically, was to make up my own little definition of subluxation that makes sense to me. Right? If it makes sense to everybody else, cool, fine, wonderful. But quite frankly, in my world, guess who it's all about? Me, right? Because I don't need for it to make sense to you. In my world, it makes sense, right? And so the definition of of subluxation that we work with incorporates not only that hard bone soft nerve model, or the stretching on the nerve model, or nerve system model, but also expands beyond that and says, you know what, other communication pathways in addition to the nerve system are also the neurochemistry and the electromagnetic field. It also recognizes that, yes, we are matter, but we are energy also. And that perhaps the subluxations are part of our learning and growing process and not just there to create dis-ease and you know, make our lives miserable, right? And so in a nutshell, the definition of subluxation that we utilize in BGI incorporates traditional model of bony misalignments and all that stuff, but then expands that. And essentially it says that ultimately if you break everything down, and this is going to be a whirlwind tour of this, ultimately if you break everything down, it is energy. Okay? The reason I'm structured the way that I am is because of the energy that I am. Okay? If you were to change my, and this is physics, if you were to change my vibration, you would change my physical expression on the planet. Every experience you have, if you break it down, whether it's physical, chemical, emotional, mental, or some combination, ultimately, when it's broken down into energy that we perceive and process that information. What differentiates one experience from another is essentially the music with which it vibrates, because it's the vibration of it that carries the information. Okay? This is all just kind of how things are. And so what my thought is that, you know what? Those experiences we have carry information. It's all an opportunity for us to learn, grow, and evolve. And essentially, if we integrate the experiences of life, that's exactly what happens. We learn, grow, and evolve. And if we don't, they end up stored in their physiology and create the subluxation. Okay? they say that we live in a holographic universe, and what that means is that the information, the infinite possibility of all there is to know that exists in the universe actually exists in every single atom. By the same token, our bodies are holographic in that the information to completely reproduce you anew, all the information necessary to produce all the chemicals, all the tissue types in your body exist in every single cell. Okay, your DNA, every single cell has the ability to produce every chemical or to be and differentiate into every type of cell in your body. What differentiates one type of cell from another is not the information that it possesses, but the information that has been activated and that it expresses. Okay, so my liver cells, that information to be liver cells has simply been activated, so that's what they express. Okay, by the same token, the world, the universe is holographic. And so really what differentiates me from this whiteboard is not the information we possess, because we both, all the atoms in me and in this whiteboard, possess the same information. We're holographic. What differentiates me from this whiteboard more is the information that has been activated and thus is, it is expressed. Are you hanging with that so far? How that's expressed is through music, vibration, tone. So what if every experience we have is an opportunity for us to activate more of that music? You know, if you have two guitars, if you sit them side by side, if you pluck the A string on one guitar, guess what? The A string on the other guitar is going to start to vibrate simply because it's in that musical field. Well, it's the same thing. If I have an experience and it has a particular frequency and tone, when that frequency and tone plays through my physiology, if I integrate it and it's an experience that I haven't had, if it's a unique frequency and tone, then if I integrate it, that's going to activate a previously dormant piece of information, of music within me. As it's activated and expresses through my physiology, it's increased the complexity of my music. Because I am on this planet, a full expression of the music that I am, if you increase the complexity of my music, you've just increased the complexity of my expression on the planet, and I've taken a little step along the path of evolution. We cool? That's if it integrates. If it doesn't integrate, then what I feel happens is that it's stored in the physiology. That creates a dissonance to the music that we are. If you create a dissonance in music, guess what happens? My physiology is going to express that. It's going to create a dissonance in the structuring or in the geometry of my body, which means all the way down to a cellular level, my body's going to distort. On a gross level, bones are going to misalign, there's going to be tension on the soft tissue, and that classic subluxation, bone out of place, nerve system tension is created. Well, in addition to that, because there's also this tonal component that we recognize, in addition to the distortion in the nerve system and in the physical geometry of my body, there's also going to be created an incoherence in the electromagnetic field, and an incoordination of the neurochemistry of the body, interfering with every communication mechanism or pathway that we know of that the innate intelligence of the body utilizes to express as its intelligence. Okay? So that's the definition of subluxation that I play with. Cool? Then what we do is, as far as the art form, we go into, okay, from this model, how do we look at the body? And essentially, here's the body. This is your body. Okay? This is a tensegrity model, and this is how you're put together. We're a combination on a physical level of hard things and stretchy things. Right? So we're bones and then all the soft tissue. And what's amazing about this kind of being put together in this way is that it's what they call pre-stressed, which means it's under tension just naturally. And what that, because it's under tension, the cool thing that's created is a huge transmission array, so that any force, whether it's a physical force or even if we just put a electrode on here and put music into it, essentially, every force is immediately translated over the entire structure. Cool? This is all the way down to the cellular level. This is how you're put together, which means any piece of information, no matter how small or no matter how big, it's immediately translated over the entire structure, which instantaneously puts every cell, either directly or indirectly, connected to and in communication with every other cell of the body. Is that cool or what? It's totally cool. And what's amazing is that if you take a look at the body and if you take a look at the techniques in chiropractic, based on this kind of modeling, things start to make sense. And remember, a huge part of BGI was about me trying to figure out how masters do what they do, and also me trying to figure out all the techniques that I've learned, even though I've never been moved to really do any one thing exclusively for very long. I have an appreciation for the logic of all of them. So in all the techniques that you learn, how do you put them together so that they make sense in a way where the person I'm serving actually determines what I do as opposed to my pet technique? Because as we also know, every technique does not work for every person, right? Can we admit that? It's absolutely true. And there's this whole thing where, well, you'll help about 80% of the people some of the time, you know, whatever that is. But when you start looking at the force dynamics and you start looking at this kind of modeling, things start to make sense. So in BGI, essentially, there's a few different major concepts. One is the idea of establishing continuity. Notice, when there's integrity in the structure, when I put a force in, it's immediately translated over the entire force. Okay? If I'm adjusting somebody and I have integrity in this tensegrity matrix, then there's a pretty good bet that when I deliver an adjustive input, an adjustive thrust, that the whole body's going to get the adjustment and the information there. Now remember, in the world that I live in, a subluxation is not just a bone out of place. In fact, when you take a look at how the body is put together, it's physiologically and anatomically impossible for one bone to move and there not being a shift throughout the entire physiology. It's physically impossible. So it's actually incongruent to say that, you know, T5 is subluxated. No, the whole body is subluxated. T5 just happens to be where you're choosing to access that. Can you hang with that? Does that make sense? The thing is, though, and if I have integrity in the tensegrity matrix of the body, then there's a pretty good bet that when I put a force in at T5, the whole system's going to get, boom, that information, right? And unless the whole system gets it, guess what? The subluxation doesn't truly release. The subluxation does not release unless the whole body gets it, right?